everybody. I'm Maureen McGuigan, Deputy Director of Arts and Culture for Lackawanna County. And today we're on the road, safely of course, for our Lackawanna County Arts and Culture Live Holiday Edition, where we're bringing you lots of fun seasonal programming. You know, and part of our mission at the department is to, you know, explore and celebrate all the different cultures. Scranton's a wonderful ethnic city. We have, of course, traditional immigrants. Now we have newer immigrants coming. And everybody has a holiday or a celebration. We also think food and cooking is an art form. So I'm thrilled today to be here at Abe's Deli, which is a longstanding business. I can't imagine not anybody not knowing Abe's Deli in downtown Scranton. But today we're going to talk about holiday foods, because that's one of the great things is that no matter what faith you follow, because food and art are also are always very tied to culture and faith, but all faiths have food that they celebrate. So I'm really thrilled to be here with the owner of Abe's Deli, Renato Longo, who's going to talk to us about different holiday foods. Today, December 10th, 2020, is actually the first day of Hanukkah, which is the 8-day celebration of lights. And of course, we all know that Christmas is celebrated by Christians on December 25th as the birth of Jesus Christ. So we're gonna talk about holiday foods with these two major celebrations that take place in December. So enough about me, let's get to the fun part. Welcome, Renato, how
thank
are
you?
I
Good.
Really
how are
appreciate
you?
Your time. Abe's is always busy and
yes,
you've
thank
done a,
God.
Yeah, I know, and you've done a great job, you know, keeping everybody safe.
Thank
so
you
it's
so
nice,
much.
Yeah, and you do take out too.
Yes, take out delivery, yep.
And safe, I should say, we're really encouraging people to shop and eat local, support our small businesses. I'm actually wearing a mask from Nodology down the street on Spruce, but there's lots of artists and businesses making masks, so support them. So first, in case our viewers don't know, why don't you tell us a little bit about your connection to the restaurant and how you ended up becoming the owner?
I started working at Abe's in 1992.
Wow.
Put my time in, I put myself through college working in the business. Fell in love with the business right off the bat, and I have a wonderful relationship with the prior owner, Jerry Mizrahi, yeah. Like a father to me. And 5 years ago, I purchased the business off him, and we've been up and running and doing a great job ever since.
Yeah, you know what? You are a business owner who really takes pride not just in your food, but in your sense of place, like. Every season, you have the beautiful tulips in the spring, and if
thank
you walk
you.
By to, you know, there's the beautiful holiday display, and you have the windows, which I love. You have Christmas on this side
yes.
and Hanukkah on this side. So, do you think that's important?
I do. I mean, I want my customers to feel that the same way if they were coming to my home. I decorate my home the same way. I shouldn't say just me, my wife. If I don't mention my wife, I'm in big trouble. But she does help me a lot with the decorations in the store as well. I feel it's very important to show that the spirit of the holiday. I want people to feel welcome, excited, and to know that I do care about what I do.
Yes, it definitely shows. So, you know, I was kind of said in my intro, one of the things that makes, well, the United States, but especially Scranton, because we have very strong community identities and cultural identities that everybody kind of partakes in. Everybody's Irish on parade day,
sure,
for example.
Right, exactly.
But, you know, this is kind of unique in that you do celebrate kind of two cultures. And what are your thoughts on that? Like, you know, blending and celebrating culture.
It was important for me, not being Jewish, when I took the business over, to definitely recognize and follow the traditions that were long-standing in the business and bring mine in as well, because back in 92, I want to say 90% of our customers were Jewish. Now in 2020, 99% are non-Jewish. And it's not because of anything we've done or changes. I just think that the population has dropped and the older generation has passed, unfortunately. But I thought it was important and to keep the non-Jewish people educated on these beautiful traditions that we have, that they cannot be lost. I don't think they should be.
No, that's beautifully said, but I like that you've also added new things and you are reflecting that there's new people moving into our community and we are being more, people are curious about other cultures. So I think that's great. You have such an awesome selection
thank
of people coming here.
Thank you very much.
I hear quite a bit. Great salmon. You'll feel very healthy. So we're going to jump into the food, but okay. I did want to say, in case people, you know, don't know the background of Hanukkah, it's a very beautiful holiday, but has a kind of long and complex history. So I encourage you to Google it. It's a really interesting history, but just in a very tiny nutshell, about over 2,000 years ago, the Jewish people in what is today is Israel were living under Greek rule and being forced to follow Greek gods. So they rebelled that took about 3 years. And even though they were outnumbered, they won and they were able to go back to their temple in Jerusalem, but they wanted to rededicate it and purify it. And so unfortunately they only had oil for one night to light the menorah. But miraculously, it was enough. It just kept burning for 8 days. So that's where you get the tradition of the 8 days of Hanukkah. And there, Renato's going to talk about this. But you know, again, food reflecting culture. So a lot of foods are fried and are kind of a homage to that idea of the oil and the light. So let's get started with the fun part now.
So, what is traditional is the potato latkes or potato pancakes. It's basically a grated potato with egg. Some people put flour. We put our matzo meal in there with some fried onion, and we fry these in oil. We make sandwiches out of these. They're also sold as a dish. But we make our brisket here. We do our brisket on top of a potato pancake with gravy. It's unbelievable.
Oh, wow.
You'll be dreaming about it once you have one of these. They're excellent.
Sounds amazing.
And of course, there's a noodle pudding, it's called, which is just noodles. There's cheese in here, cranberries, walnuts. There's some brown sugar. This is baked in the oven. This is a kugel. It's traditional. There's a million ways to make a kugel. I just thought this would be a little different. There's potato kugel, there's noodle, there's all different kinds.
So this is kind of your own original
That we, you know, added a little twist of our own.
Oh, nice.
Some people put cottage cheese. I put ricotta cheese in here. This is a delicious, and then of course our dessert are the jelly donuts.
Yeah.
The souvenir, is what you would call them. Raspberry filled fried donuts, excellent.
Yeah, they look amazing.
They're very, very good. And of course, there's other meals, but these are the main staple of what customers would be ordering for the holidays.
For the holidays, again, I think often holidays and celebrations are times when we do have those big meals that we don't normally would eat. So how long does it kind of take to make all of these? Are they challenging?
The brisket is, we slow cook this. This takes a few hours in the oven. This has a balsamic glaze on it. You could make it with a tomato sauce. You could make it with just some onions on top. This is just something different because we thought it would complement the pancake a little better with the glaze on it. This takes about 4 hours to cook.
Oh, wow, yeah.
They're a lot bigger normally. They're about a 13-pound piece.
Really?
This is a smaller piece because I knew you guys were coming and I had to make a little quicker. So one is a lot smaller. So these are our first cuts and these take about 2 hours. But anyway, they're excellent. They melt in your mouth. The briskets are very, very good, especially the kosher meat, the best meat you can buy. Potato pancakes don't take long at all. The kugel, about an hour in the oven at 350, and that's not really a long process. And the donuts, I can't take credit for those. We get these in from New York.
That's okay. Yeah, this is a beautiful meal. So did I hear you correctly? Because that sounded amazing. You make you put the brisket on the potato pancake.
So we sometimes we used to make the potato pancakes thicker, but we make them a little thinner now because we put the meat on top and make a sandwich out of it.
Have to get that. Yeah.
And we started that during our Passover holiday years back when we don't serve bread on our holiday. So instead of sandwiches on bread, we did them on potato pancakes.
Well, that kind of leads into my next question. You talked about falling in love with the business. I mentioned I really do think food and cooking are art. This is kind of creative for you then. Do you find your recipes and coming up with things like a creative process for you?
Yeah, I mean, there's times at night I'll, you know, go through the internet or look at different recipes and try to blend other things. The most important thing in this business, I believe, is not to stay the same. Mm-hmm. You have to always create new things because not only if you have your customers coming every day, which most of our customers are just repeat customers, they get bored as well. So you have to have new things and diets change over the years. And
I mean, we've started with quinoa salads mm-hmm. and a lot of quinoa dishes and vegetarian, vegan. Yeah. So you have to change in that sense.
Yeah, I love that you're able to pay homage maybe to some of the traditional stuff, but then adapt. You do have a great, I always tell, healthy menu. But really, you can get all kinds of food here, and that's what
Thank
makes
you,
this
yeah.
place fun. So are these special items that people can order too? Do
yes.
you have people that come for?
Yes,
you know?
Actually, today we've the donuts we've sold already. I think over 10 dozen, and
wow.
this is just our first day. Our yeah. potato pancakes. I couldn't even tell you how many we sold already.
Really?
I have Pete, my chef in the back. He's been making them all day long. And I want to say hundreds went out the door, thank God. Our briskets, we make to order. A lot of our customers, I should say last year, there were a lot of big orders. But of course, the situation that we have now, and
yeah.
this is what the smaller pieces help. This can feed about 8 people.
Oh,
and what we do is slice it and we put them in a pan and have everything ready, so they just have to reheat them in the oven, and they come out just like they would here right out.
Can
of
make
the
your holidays easy.
That
would be great.
That's what we're trying to do.
So yeah, that smells heavenly. That's the sauce and everything.
Thank you.
So, you know, jumping back to maybe the traditions that you grew up with. You know, we were kind of talking about different cultures. Do you have any family traditions you grew up? As an Italian-American?
Oh, yes, of course, yeah. I mean, we have so many that I try to hold on to. My mother makes certain cookies during the holidays. And what I try to do is try to incorporate those with our kosher, with our kosher ingredients to try to make them here so that we can sell it to our customers to enjoy as well. Because I do have to stay with the kosher, the rules, you know. And we try to keep that as close as we can.
But again, that's that creativity. You're kind of blending two things.
Yeah,
and
we have to. I mean, it's funny because I'm first generation Italian. I grew up speaking the language in Italian, so it's important to me to keep those traditions.
Mm-hmm.
But it's also very important to keep the ones that I learned from Jerry and
Aww.
From this business. So I try to incorporate both of them. And I know that tonight I will go home with my wife and my kids, and we'll celebrate Hanukkah tonight.
Aww.
So we have a great time celebrating
That's
the
great.
Holidays. Yeah.
I think this is such a positive interview for the time, and it's really what the United States should be about, us all supporting and learning and
yes.
and adapting
right.
Things into our lives. Just as Americans, we can celebrate our differences and come together.
Right.
Yeah, I was trying to think, you know, in the Irish tradition, I have to look up why this is. We were not as we have oyster stew on Christmas Eve.
Right.
I think because also in the Christian faith, there was a time of like before the celebration, you know, holding back, you know, during Lent. They don't. So I've
right.
read that like the Italians have the seven fishes,
right?
Yeah, some of that's tied
to
that.
A lot of that stuff I would love to bring in. However, the fishes that we eat are. Not considered kosher, so we weren't allowed.
Oh,
I wouldn't be allowed to bring those into the store to share that with the customers. But definitely at my house on Christmas Eve,
yeah.
we have that.
Because
yes.
what are they? There's the dried
cod, which is bacala. Cod we could use, but the how they dry it, it may not be on the same level that we could use, so we can't bring that in. There's clams, there's squid, calamari, all that stuff we're not allowed to use. That's not a kosher fish. So
what is, you know, kosher, what is the history behind that?
Well,
there's
bottom feeders on the Jewish customers cannot have. That's
okay.
not a kosher fish. The salmon, flounder, there's cod. All that stuff is kosher, but the ones that eat off the bottom of the ocean, they're not considered a kosher.
Well, it's really interesting. And,
yeah.
you know, part of this program is to educate people. Like I mentioned, you know, in the Christian faith, you know, you don't eat meat on Friday. So there's a lot of these things that, you know, we need to respect and learn from.
Right.
So I think that's very interesting.
Yeah.
But, you know, again, like the fact that you were thinking about your Italian cookies and how you could do that.
Right.
There's a lot of opportunity. But yeah, so I just wanted to bring up your heritage. And like I mentioned, and there's so many. I was talking to a friend of mine who's Mexican-American, and they make, they have lots of things, and there's a cake they make, I'm going to mispronounce it, Reyes, because they put a little figure of Christ in there, and whoever gets that has
right.
to,
yeah,
there's a lot
nice.
Of traditions like that.
Yes.
I know in the Irish tradition, it's for St. Patrick's Day, they'll put like a ring. This sounds dangerous to me, but like a ring, a penny, a thimble. And like, if you get the ring, you're supposed to get married. If you get the penny, I think if you get the thimble, like, you're not going to do too well. But I love those because I think, again, they tell a story of our histories, right, and our culture as a people. So
it's important to have, you know, our culture, and it's important to keep our traditions alive, because if you get rid of that, what else do you have? I mean, you have to hold on to something.
Right.
And, you know, and teach our children the things that we did. And I feel a lot of that is lost these days.
Yeah.
And it's very important to me to keep that.
Yeah, I think that's, again, why we try to educate. You know, we're sitting here, I'm thinking my Polish friends have a whole, like, again, sort of like the 12, they do a whole, there's like 12 different, and
right,
again, they don't use meat at that time, I think,
right,
because they're holding back at that time of year. So yeah, I love keeping those alive.
Right.
We did a little program, it was a Christmas tree craft, but I didn't know if a lot of people know that the Christmas tree originated in Germany. So that's a very German tradition, which is then brought to America, and
right,
now a very popular symbol of Christmas.
Right.
So there's a lot of these interesting stories.
It is,
so.
Yes.
But again, I think food is the ultimate connector. It brings us together. So
right,
how can people, you know, order from you? They can obviously come in.
You can obviously come in. You can call us 570-342-4517. You can, we have Instagram. We're on Facebook. All that stuff, you can get in touch with us one way or the other. We're open 7 days a week, Monday through Friday, 6:30 to 4 o'clock, Saturday, 9:30 to 3:30. And on Sunday, 7 to 3:30.
Yeah, you have great breakfast here too. So
yeah,
there's
we have
something
breakfast, lunch,
for
yeah,
all. Yeah. So, and then I should have said the address. I'm such a Scrantonian.
Yeah.
I just know. So, what is your
address
for people who might not be?
326 North Washington Avenue.
Yeah, and again, it's worth it just to walk by. Hopefully, you should come in. But I mean, again,
right,
you just do a beautiful job with the cityscape
very, very
out there. Well, I want to thank you for their time. Is there anything else you'd like to say about your business or cooking?
I just want to thank all my customers and the loyalty that you've shown over, especially this year.
Yeah.
It's humbling to us and everybody in the store, and we're grateful. And we promise to try to keep doing the best we can and serving the community. And we want to be a staple of downtown until this, whenever.
Yeah.
You know, I would like to stay in. Hopefully my children would be here one day.
Aww.
And working and doing our thing. But
yeah,
we'd like to thank everybody, because it, you know, the support that was shown during this pandemic is just, it's emotional to me, because I can't get over all of the people and how they reached out and helped us all.
Well, I have to say, you're one of the kind, you are so nice to all of us. When
thank
we come
you
in here, like you were saying in the beginning, it does feel like a second home.
Thank you.
It's a place you want to be. It's, you know, it just has a warmth to it. The food's amazing. So I'm really happy we were able to talk to you about some of the Jewish traditions, and
right,
even got into a little
right
bit of some of the other cultural traditions at this time of year. So
thank you so much for
so
coming.
Thank you, and we encourage you to come down to Abe's Deli and all year long. But if you want some of these amazing special holiday treats, come on down. Thank you for watching.
Thank you.